Hello, and welcome to Old Scary World. Sorry it's been so long since I've done a video. I've been very busy, and if you want to see more of my work and research and art, you can follow me on Instagram. I'm a little bit more active there. But with that said, I'd like to become a little bit more active on here like I used to be, so I apologize, and hopefully this video is the beginning of weekly uploads like before. So this video is going to be a little bit different, as most all other ones are. And I thought I'd do a video here about stone. I wouldn't necessarily call them carvings, although some of them are. Some of them are quote-unquote natural formations that appear to take the shape or the likeness of what we would consider human or possibly giant in nature. Like this hand, for instance. You see, I mean, clearly fingered. You know, people say that it was made by humans, you know, that it's just too on the nose or it's too perfect to be a natural formation. And in any case, it really doesn't matter whether it's natural or unnatural. It's still interesting. It's very ominous, very foreboding. And so in any case, whether it's natural or unnatural or normal or paranormal, it's a sight to be seen. And I don't know where this is. Didn't catch that. This isn't really about where things are. This is more about what things are. And obviously that's open to interpretation as well. Leave it in the comments. Let's just go to the next image here. All right, so another one that's clearly 99.99% sure that this was made by human hands. See, it's like a depiction kind of like a old lady, like Baba Babushka here, and she's holding up the rest of the cave at the side of this mountain, or you know, whatever. Maybe it's like sandstone, and sandstone's pretty easy to carve. It's pretty easy to manipulate. It's really crumbly and porous. Yeah, it seems pretty good detail here. I mean, she's only got three visible fingers, you know, like that. But hey, you know, that's the way it goes. She's got like a little dress on. Got like a little bonnet, you know. She's got some ruffles. Pretty cool. You know, like if I was coming up on this, if I was on a nature hike or something and I came up on this, you know, I'd be like, whoa, what's up with that? So, really, and then the thing about these things is no one really knows how old they are, you know, unless they happen to be there when it was made or something, or they know somebody that knew somebody. But, you know, I'd reckon that these are all pretty, pretty old. So, anyways, so that's a good one. So, let's go to the next one. See, that's just as good. All right, so this one's a little different, you know. It's kind of like a goose or some type of waterfowl, you know. Somebody might say a dinosaur looking, but those things are fake enough as it is. So it's probably like a goose, you know. I don't know. I think it looks like a goose. I have no idea where it is. And there's some stuff down here going on. Some big steps. Kind of like an amphitheater or something like that. So, you know, that's interesting or whatever. Looks pretty old. He's got an eyeball socket. And this one here is like, kind of tilt your head, but it's like a beach. But it works better like this, you know, because you see the profile. Looks like a female, you know. Here's got her eyes closed. You know, this one's pretty cool. This is another one of those ones where even if it was created by man, it took a lot of work and, you know, had to think things through really with this one. So that's pretty cool. And if it formed naturally, quote unquote naturally, yeah, that's pretty weird too. So just like all the other ones, you know, either way, you know, it's a win-win. So I think I've seen this one before, and this is a pretty well-known one. Like I said, I don't know where any of these are, but if I had to take a bet, I'd say it seems kind of Asian-ish, you know, maybe like Southeast Asia or something like that, like Thailand or, you know, who knows, I don't know, maybe Sumatra or something. Alright, so then this one, this one I'm not too sure about, to be honest, and if it's a forgery, if you know it's a forgery for sure, let me know in the comments. I included it because it's like visually, you know, kind of cool, if it's real, but, you know, part of me is thinking it's too good to be true because it's just, it's, you know, it's pretty big and all that kind of stuff, but it just kind of seems fake, to be honest. That's kind of why I included it, because I wasn't sure. I kind of wanted your guys' opinion, because something seems like a little off, like the color here. Yeah, it's like this. It's like a dark blue, gray, almost like purple, and then it goes to this like kind of mossy green. I don't know if it's real. If anybody knows if it's fake, just let me know in the comments or whatever. So that's my disclaimer on this one, is I'm not claiming authentic. I'm not claiming it's authenticity on that. Sorry. This one, you know, this one's interesting to me because it seems like a waterfall used to come through here or something, but then it's like two eyes, almost kind of like reptilian or amphibian looking. I mean, some people might say it looks like an owl too, but you can kind of see where maybe there was like an ancient waterfall, like back in the old days, maybe at one point. Or it could be like a flood wash, like maybe once a year it gets a big, you know, and then the rest of the year it's dry. I don't know. That's what it kind of seems like to me. And then this seems like it could be like a trail. There might even be a person here, not sure. But it could be part of the wash. Like water comes down here and then it actually caps off here. But these definitely look like eyeballs. And then you could even say these are like shoulders or something. And this is like a strange kind of torso. And then you see these big formations of lichen, which is like a type of moss kind of, you know, thing. That's what it looks like to me. As with all the other pictures, if anybody knows anything, just let me know in the comments. But I like this one too. This one's interesting. Definitely some uniformity here, like this. Eye sockets. So, you know, like I said, some people say it's man-made, some people say it's melted, some people say this, some people say that, some people think that it's a giant fossil. I mean, whatever floats your boat, you know, at this point, how fast things are speeding up here towards the end, I can't really discredit anything, you know, unless it's like super goofy. But yeah, like that's what I'm trying to say. Like, if somebody said to me, like, "Hey, I think that's a fossil," I'd be like, "Okay, all right, that's a lot less goofy than some of the stuff that's floating around these days on various subjects, if you know what I mean." So, anyways, let's go to the next one. So this one's like clearly like, okay, this is supposed to be like Neptune or you know, Poseidon or something, like some other like water deity. I mean, clearly, I mean, come on, I mean, right? Okay, so then here he's got like in his hand, he's got like some type of reptile or something he's like crushing. He's got something under his control. He's being, you know, dominant over this thing. And then is that his tail, like a snake, like a body of a snake, and then that's his head, or what's going on with that? But you see like the detail here on his beard. Yeah, so we put a lot of time into this. I mean, it's pretty obvious this is like a statue, but what's cool about it It makes it a little bit more interesting than a regular statue, is that it's carved into the side of this, you know, hillside, this little step here, this little cliff, or whatever. Moss, you know, obviously somebody's coming and scraping the moss off so people can see it. Somebody's taking care of it. It doesn't look like it's been, you know, vandalized too bad or anything like that. So that's cool. You know, once again, I don't know where this is, but that really doesn't matter to me. Maybe it matters to some people, you know, they can look into it or something, I don't know. But to me, don't really care. Okay, here's another one. This one, I've seen this one around before. You know, this one's pretty cool too, and it's got like a little cave underneath here or something. But what's cool about this one is it's more blocky. You know, he like his beard, you know. It's got like this crystal kind of characteristic to it, almost like stalactites or something like that. But it's outside, and there's something weird about this one, you know, because it's so chunky here, almost like barnacles looking, but then it's like smooth here, smooth there, pretty smooth here. And you can see like the person put a lot of detail in this one. It's got like muscle, almost like muscle groups, you know, smooth there, but then it's got this like chunky stuff. Yeah, I mean, look how well chiseled this guy's nose is here, his eye sockets, he's looking down, his eyebrows. You know, I just don't understand the difference here. Maybe somebody can explain it. Why some of the stuff's like really chunky and some of the stuff's really smooth. But it obviously adds to the effect of the piece here. And then these are random blocks here. You know, it's almost like two different time periods. Like these are way newer than whatever this is made out of. It almost seems like it's completely different. Like these are just put here like a wall. Like this was built around this. Like this statue is older than this structure. You know? Or maybe the statue is really old and then this is some type of after effect too. But kind of seems intentional. Like it's really just mostly in the areas of hair, like beard, eyebrows, head hair, and he's got a little bit here on his legs and stuff, but I don't know. If anybody knows the story with this one, let me know. Yeah. Okay, now this one, I almost didn't put this one in because it's a little too, you know, it's kind of silly, if you ask me. I'm not going to say what it looks like, you know. I think it's pretty obvious to any adult, you know, in the room. And this channel's not crude, you know. This is about as crude as it gets right here, if you know what I mean. But let's take a step back for a second and look at more of the symbology of birth and the miracle of life, you know, and all that kind of stuff. So this guy's coming out of that. It's a tree. Yeah, it's interesting. It's kind of heart-shaped, you know. It's an interesting angle, obviously. Obviously, the photographer was taking advantage of angles and perspective on this one. And I'll just kind of leave it at that. You know, it's just kind of like a chuckle. You know, but like I said, that's about as crude as I'll get on this channel, okay? It's about as crude as anybody needs to get, really. Just take that in for a second. Ha ha. Hee hee ho ho. Okay. So this one, I saved the best. Well, maybe not the best, but I saved the most interesting for last. Here, we got these screaming heads here. Now, what's interesting about this one is there's elements of design and then there's elements of random, you know, randomness. Here, like a melted, and the nostrils, eyes, but then that's like, were these like little apartments? Like, were these like little, like, dwellings at some point? You know, and then were there more? Were there more here? And then they got like melted over, they got covered over. I mean, like I said, I don't know, but it's pretty sinister. It's kind of scary looking. And anybody knows more, let me know. But that's not what this video is about. You know, this video is more about just getting a dialogue with some of these, you know. And I hadn't done a video in a while, and I just kind of felt like doing something kind of off like this. I got some other videos planned, and if you're sticking with me this long, just bear with me for a couple more minutes, and I got a bonus, you know, a little extra special bonus after this. So yeah, that's all for now, and hopefully some more videos soon, on location videos and all that kind of stuff. And I'm still working on the podcast. I gotta get that, trying to get that going before the year's over. And like I said, there's just a lot more stuff going on in the Instagram. It's just easier to upload there. So if you're not already following me on Instagram, please follow me on Instagram at MudfloodMemes or Old Scary World. Same thing, you'll find me there. And if this is your first time watching, this isn't how most of my videos are, at least not the subject matter, but just kind of felt like doing one about these weird statues and melted looking things and stuff like that. So, as always, thank you for watching. Goodbye. All right, as promised, I said that I would have a bonus face reveal for all my subscribers over the last almost couple of years now. And I started to think that it wasn't very Christian, it wasn't very honest to, I wouldn't say conceal, but not be forthcoming with my visage. And I was thinking about some videos and I was like, well, I'm gonna have to show myself eventually for that type of video, and if I ever do the video cast, the video podcast, and so forth. So, yeah, that's it. No ski mask, no big sunglasses, no face, you know, distortion or voice distortion. It's, I think almost 1 o'clock in the morning here, and in my office studio, you know, den. And yeah, so that's it. So I hope that puts to rest any rumors or any hearsay or any lies about who I am or what I look like. And yeah, so I expect, you know, varying degrees of input, but now that that's out of the way, I just want to say thank you to all my subscribers and all my followers on Instagram and Telegram and so forth, and all the people that have encouraged me and supported me over the last couple of years. Very appreciated, and I don't really don't know what else to say. Probably going to do some more videos like this, maybe some live streams with all of this. And what this is, you know, changes sometimes depending on my mood. But as far as facial hair or hats or sweatshirts or whatever. But yeah, and I don't always talk like this. Okay, that's something that I did in the beginning because I hadn't ever made YouTube videos. I didn't have a very good mic. And, you know, but going on podcasts and doing interviews and stuff like that, gotten a little bit more comfortable. And, you know, I have a lot of different voices. And that monotonous voice that I tend to have, regardless, was a little bit more accentuated like that in the beginning. And, you know, I could always go back to that if I feel like it. So it is what it is. But I don't want this to be a negative thing or anything like that. I want this to be a positive thing. And I don't want to keep it too long. So with that said, just once again, thanks for supporting Old Scary World and Mudflood Memes and all that stuff. It means a lot to me. And, you know, to all the people who have bought merch and, you know, sent super chats and all that kind of stuff, that really, it really warms my heart. And it's not really the only thing that keeps it going, but it definitely helps a lot. So I appreciate all that. And thank you for watching this far. And as always, thank you for watching. Goodbye.